Huh? I feel the warm sun dancing on my face as my eyes squint open, confused. A fresh breeze drifts in and I smell a familiar scent. The forest by my old house. I can't be. My eyes bolt open and I sit up fast, taking in my surroundings. I don't believe it. I see pale yellow walls surrounding me. The posters of Washington crossing the Delaware and a US map. The rickety wood bookshelf in the corner of the room, and I'm laying on my old but comfy bed. I'm home. How in the hell did this happen? There's no way any of this was real. But I needed proof. It was accurate, but it was all too accurate. I fling myself out of bed, noticing I have a slight headache, but I ignore it. It's time to get to the bottom of this. I look out my window, down to the forest. If this was some fabricated illusion, it looks all pretty realistic. The tree to the far right even had HB cross BB still carved in it. Ugh, what an idiot I was for dating- No, focus, focus, Barry, come on! Remember what happened! I close my eyes tight and concentrate, seeing vague shapes, arrows flying at me, a red-headed woman standing over me. But who was it?
Trying to imagine a reality where you don't have a bunch of trig homework piling up? Hate to break it to you, bro, but there isn't one.
I jump at the familiar voice of my sister and open my eyes again. She's standing in the frame of my door with a sly smile.
You coming? Dad made waffles.
Dad?
You know, the guy that's raised you all your life? The reason we celebrate Father's Day? Jeez, you really are trying to escape reality, aren't you?
You never call him Dad, though. Not around me, at least.
What else would I call him? Come on, weirdo. Maybe getting some breakfast and you will fix your hunger-fueled delusions.
Kate shakes her head and walks downstairs. What's going on? Am I imagining all this? Or is it really real? Well, I am hungry. Maybe I was just having a bad dream before. I mean, that would explain why I remember fewer and fewer details. I follow the path my sister took down the stairs and am surprised when I hear laughter filling up the dining room. A usually glum and hopeless space. I think.
And that's why we need a new boat.
Hey, what can I say? It was my first time fishing.
At least it sounded like it went better than my first time. Do you remember how soaked we got, Derek?
I don't think I ever truly dried off after that.
Oh, now you gotta tell me that story.
Well, it... Oh, good morning, sleepyhead. We've got some waffles and maple syrup here for you if you're hungry.
I walk into the kitchen and I can't believe my eyes. Not only was my father smiling at me, warmly, not cruelly even, but sitting next to him was a woman I hadn't seen in 16 years. Eleanor Bishop. My mom. Tears started stinging my eyes and everyone's smiles grew into looks of concern.
What's wrong, sweetie?
Mom gets up from her seat and steps closer. I couldn't help myself. I rushed forward and hugged her. Her warm embrace felt so comforting. I'm just so happy to see you.
Aw, baby, I'm glad to see you too. Now why don't you have a seat and eat something before your breakfast gets cold?
Alright. Thanks, Mom. She gives my cheek a soft kiss, and I take her suggestion. Sitting in my usual seat and snack a few hot waffles with my fork. I can't shake this feeling, though. Everything was better than I remembered it being. Could this really be... No, Barry, you're remembering it wrong, aren't you? You're beating yourself up. You deserve to be happy. Aren't you happy? I smiled as I took a bite of my waffle.
Mmm, this is so good.
You can thank your dad for them. You've really come far since the first burnt pizza you made that time all those years ago.
Oh, it's all thanks to YouTube. You never know what you'll find on there.
I didn't even realize you knew how to use a computer.
Oh yes, hilarious. Make fun of your old man. Who do you think set up the router?
I was still in shock. This isn't at all what my family was like in my old memories. Dad was cool and distant. Kate was scared and always nervous at home, and Mom was gone. I continue thinking about these people and how vastly different they are from the people I can see right in front of me. These memories. They had to be some kind of nightmare still lingering around. That explains it. My head hurts again as I see images flash before my eyes. A man stabbed in the chest by some costumed swordsman. An arrow jabbing me right in the shoulder.
The Ringmaster saved me. He saved both of you too.
And who was this Ringmaster?
Barry?
Sorry. Did you say something?
I should be apologizing. It looks like I interrupted a deep thought.
Got an idea for another harebrained invention? I'm telling you, if we put more thought into those gliding wings, we could get them working.
Just as long as I don't have to take you to the hospital. Again.
No, Derek, that's all right. You keep eating your breakfast. I'll go see who it is.
Thanks, honey. I won't argue with you there. These waffles are just too good to leave behind.
Should I leave you two alone?
Maybe.
Well, that answers my question. Hannah, hey, it's good to see you. Come in.
Thanks, Mrs. Bishop.
My ears perk up. Hannah. I can't remember the last time I saw her. But it had to have been recently, right? I mean, we are dating. Apparently. My mind starts to trail off with a question eating away at me. What if I was in some sort of vivid dream? What if this really isn't real? What if my memories are actual memories of what really happened? And if this is a dream, how would I even get out of a dream? I've always heard that you can't die inside of one, but if I was wrong, then, well...
You there, Barry?
What? I'm pulled out of my thoughts yet again by a pretty brunette with cold hazel eyes looking down at me, arms crossed impatiently. Oh! Hey, Hannah.
Jeez, dude. Where does your mind keep wandering off to?
Not to another girl, I hope.
No! No, definitely not!
Good.
Would you guys mind if we stepped out for a moment?
Go for it, dear.
Ooh, are you guys gonna go make out now?
Kate. I get out of my chair and lightly take Hannah's hand, leading her out of the house and into a breezy summer morning. I take her to a nearby tree with a few swings Dad made back when we were kids, I think, and take a seat. Hannah turns to me and smiles.
So, are we gonna make out?
Huh? What? No! I mean, it's not that I don't want to. Trust me, I do. Besides the point, I've got a lot on my mind. I'm starting to second guess my choice of confiding in Hannah. I mean, if anyone would listen to my crazy thoughts, it was Kate, but then again, she seems different now. Happier, yes, but still different. Not like the Kate I think that I know. She was weirded out when I questioned her about calling Derek Dad. Hannah does seem willing to listen at the very least. She takes my hand in hers and looks me in the eyes.
Anything I can help with?
I just feel like I don't belong here.
What do you mean? Don't you get along with your family? It always seems like it every time I'm over there.
It's not that. Things are great with them. Better than it's ever been. At least, I think it is? I'm confused, Hannah. It's like I have this other version of my life that I remember, but it's so different from where I am now. Hannah just stares at me for a moment, seemingly trying to figure out what to do with the information I just shared, and how to respond to it.
Barry, look, I can't lie. That's probably the weirdest thing anyone has ever said to me. But it sounds like it's all in your head. It'd be for the best if you forget about all those dreams. They're clearly getting you confused. You're here now, and that's all that matters.
But what if they are real? What if this is the dream?
That's ridiculous, okay? Just let them go.
Let them go. I wanted to do what Hannah was telling me. It made sense. let them go. But I couldn't get rid of how real my dreams felt. I closed my eyes for a moment and thought about them again, really focusing on them. Suddenly, I'm somewhere else. It looks like some sort of storage space with large shelves with boxes lining the walls. I turn to my right and see Kate firing a volley of arrows at a strangely dressed man with a sword running at her. An arrow zips past me and barely misses my arm, catching me off guard. A guy in front of me fires another one without a second thought. I have to act quick. I roll out of the way, already hearing yet another head in my way. Wait, what the hell? I have a bow in my hand, and a quiver filled with arrows on my back. I wasn't defenseless after all, and I'm going to let my foe know it. I knock in a few arrows and shoot them back at the man. Wait, why do I know how to use this? He keeps on dodging them like me, but he's so much better. I feel a sharp pain in my shoulder, and I fall down hard on the ground.
The Ringmaster saved me. She saved both of you too. I owe her. We owe her. This is what must be done.
End of line, traitor! Traitor!
Traitor! You and your sister screwed everything up. You both will pay dearly. My organization will make sure of it. For now, sleep.
Barry!
Sleep. My eyes are open. But instead of being awake, I feel like I'm back asleep. Hannah stands right in front of me, looking perturbed, but I didn't focus on her for long. Just behind her, I saw someone run by, with a flash of scarlet. I don't know what was drawing me to follow them, but I listened to my gut and got off the swing, sprinting, leaving Hannah
Barry,
behind.
Where the hell are you going?
I run full force into the woods, not caring what happens to me. I need answers! I weave in and out to dodge low-hanging branches, desperately looking around for that scarlet figure. Come on, show yourself. I'm about ready to give up. It's getting harder to keep this pace, but then, finally, I see them, long red hair flowing back as they run deeper into the forest. I'm not letting them get away. I charge after them with newfound energy. I keep my eyes locked on the redhead. To my surprise, they disappear in a flash. I stop instantly in my tracks, confused as hell. Frantically searching. I don't need to search anymore. A ginger-haired woman with a fierce look on her face pops right in front of me and shoves me hard into the nearest tree. When I'm slammed into the tree, I hit my head, and it all comes flooding back at me at once. The circus of crime.
Welcome, bro.
The Ringmaster.
You both will join my heist crew.
Stark Enterprises, Kate, the bow and arrow. That was all real. I'm in a coma. I'm in a coma.
You're causing an awful amount of trouble for someone who has everything they ever wanted.
But it's not real. I won't let you trap me here. Kate needs me!
Oh, and why the hell do you think Kate needs you? She's doing perfectly fine without you. Better, in fact. Why don't you tell him, Kate?
Kate steps out from behind the Ringmaster with a smile unlike I've ever seen her have before. It was filled with malice.
She's right, Barry. You're nothing but a failure. You couldn't even protect me from Trickshot and the Swordsman. You're nothing but a useless waste of my time. Do you know how often I visit the hospital to see you just to keep up appearances with all my new friends? I could have done anything. And I mean anything. And it would have been a better way to spend my time.
No. You're lying. I don't believe you. You're not the real Kate!
Deep down, Barry, you know she is. You know you always held her back.
No, I haven't. I've never held her back. How could you say something like that? I've never held her back. I've never! No! No, I never! I couldn't have! No! No. Yes. Yes, I have. I have held her back. I do hold her back. You're right. I can't believe I was so blind.
Oh, it's all right, Barry. You can make it up to her. You'll be there for her every day now. You don't have anything to worry about. You'll be here with everyone. Everyone that loves you.
I feel a weight lift off of my shoulders, and my mind clear. One by one, everyone that I love stepped out from behind the trees. A happier Kate. A happier Dad. Hannah. Mom. I smiled at all of them. The Ringmaster wasn't my enemy. She was my salvation.
So, Barry, will you stay?
This is where my family is. This is where I belong. I do belong here. Yes. I will stay.
You made the right choice, Barry. I'll let you be with your family now. Enjoy them.
The Ringmaster disappears from my view as my family closes in. All of them grinning ear to ear at me. I share a comfortable hug with them, feeling happier than I ever have in my life. I was home.
We've done all that we can, caught every specialist possible. There's nothing we can do. It's up to him now.
There's gotta be something you haven't tried. What about Dr. Strange?
Even he tried. Nothing. Miss Bishop, you might have to accept
that. No, he's not gonna die. I'll save him. I have to save him.
They'll keep trying, right?
Of course. We'll go back over our notes. Try everything again.
Thanks, Doc. There's nothing we can do right now, Kate. We should head home. We will find an answer to this, okay? The Ringmaster can't hide forever.
All right, let's go. Come back home, Barry.
For the benefit of Mr. Kite, there will be a show tonight on trampoline. The Hendersons will all be there. Late of Pablo, think it's fair. What a scene of a man and horses, hoops and garters. Lastly, through a hogshead of real fire. In this way, Mr. K will change the world. The celebrated Mr. K performs his feat on Saturday at a bishop's gate. Hendersons will dance and sing as Mr. Kite flies through the ring. Don't be late. Mrs. K and H assure the public their production will be second to none. And of course, Henry the Horse dances the waltz. Six when Mr. K performs his tricks without a sound.